So the repair on the bandsaw vise worked really well. I was able to hold this piece and cut off about a quarter inch. So I started with a 2-inch wide, 50 millimeter wide piece of steel there. Yeah, so this one we have to cut down to 1 3/4 inches, and this will be a block of steel that we're going to make a pair of axle pinion shims for a early model Jeep, probably a CJ3 or something like that. They have springs that are only 1 3/4 inch wide, so we'll be cutting a 12 degree angle in this block after we drill it for a center hole. And then I've got to take this block of steel here, and this one we're cutting down to 2 3/4 inches. And then here we've got a piece of stock that's already been cut to width 2.5 and length is 5. This one's going to be a 1.5 degree shim there. And then just to show you what the finished shims look like, here's one of our finished ones we have. This was a 6 degree 2 3/8 by 6 inches. So we've got the pocket here for the center bolt drilled in the middle. We have it stamped with the angle, even stamped the angle on the end of the shim there. Once it's installed on the truck, you can look on the back face and see the angle. And then if you pull the springs off of the axle, you can see that the number stamped on that face too. We start with a hunk of steel, we cut it to length, cut it to width, mark and drill a center hole, and then we cut the shims out and machine a pocket in there, stamp them with the angle, clean them up, paint them. What the shims do is they change the angle of your axle relative to the leaf springs, and depending on which way you install the shim and how steep it is, you can tip your axle up or down, and what that does is it corrects the alignment on your drive shaft. So if you've installed a suspension lift or done something to the suspension, any number of things can cause the angle to be off, so you may need to install a shim to correct the pinion angle. So like this one is a pretty small correction, just 1.5 degrees. This one will be a much bigger correction. It'll be a 12 degree shim, so we'll be cutting the whole diagonal there. This one's kind of in the middle, 6 degrees. So we do all sorts of angles, any angle you want, any length, any width. Once you start modifying the suspension and the drivetrain on a vehicle, you might need shims, you might need drive shaft spacers, you might need both. It's not just a really simple answer. I know when I first got into modifying my truck, I found a web page that said, oh, a 3-inch suspension lift, you need a 3-degree shim. Maybe in one particular case you might need something like that, but in general, that sort of rule doesn't apply. You need the shim that corrects whatever angle offset you have, not some formula in a book that says, you know, 3-inch lift, 3-degree shim. Well, there's the 3-degree shim that I originally bought, 3 degrees right there. I used it and it turned out I didn't need it. You don't always need to add a shim if you put a suspension lift on. It depends on the type of lift you have, the type of drivetrain you have, the type of drive shaft, the joints on the drive shaft, and all that sort of thing. So once I figured that out and I took the shim out, everything was okay. My drive shaft vibration went away. So there's not a simple table that you can look up, you know, this vehicle needs this shim or this lift needs that shim. You need to figure out what, in fact, that you really do need. Yeah, so this customer here has actually ordered a set of longer center bolts, and you can see the purpose of that pocket there in the top of the shim is that allows the head of the bolt to sit flush to the shim so that when you tighten this bolt down, the head isn't put under stress. So it comes out square on this side, but the bolt head would be at a severe angle, if you didn't put that pocket in there, you can see how that would cause this bolt head to want to bend over, and then this end is straight, so you would put a severe kink in the bolt right there, and it's going to weaken and break. So that's the purpose of this pocket in our shims. So yeah, this shows kind of the range of sizes. This is among the smallest shims we make, 1¾ for the early model Jeeps. This is probably for an FJ60 Toyota Land Cruiser, the 2¾-inch wide. We do 3-inch wide for some of the newer Ford models, 2⅜ wide, 2½ for the Jeeps. Pretty much any width, any length, any angle within reason. I think we've done either 15, I think we did a 17-degree shim once. These are 12, these are 5. Anything from 1 degree up about as high an angle as you can imagine. I'll put a link to our webpage. We have a ton of information on how to measure for shims because these are built to match your vehicle. So you need to tell us how long your spring perch is, how wide your springs are, and then what angle you want the shims to be, and then do you need a 5/16 or 8mm center bolt, or do you need a 3/8 or 10mm center bolt. We also do 7/16, 1/2 inch. We do the shims, these are bolt-on. So the idea with bolt-on shims is you run the center bolt through the shim, and then you put this on the bottom or on top of your leaf pack, so you have all your other leaf springs here. You put the nut on, tighten this all together, and this shim is now bolted to your springs. The other option we have is we can make these in what we call a weld-on version, where you have a hole big enough to fit the head of the bolt into, and then you weld the shim to your axle, and then you just drop the head of your center pin in your leaf springs into the hole, and then that is what locates your spring and axle together. So we do bolt-on, weld-on, various size holes, because these things all matter. So we can do custom sizes, holes, lengths, widths, angles. Check out the link to our webpage in the video description. I'll also put it in the end screen over here. And yeah, if you have any questions on that, post up in the comment section below. Yeah, so I gotta get these packed up here this afternoon and off to the post office. So I guess I gotta run. As always, thanks for watching.